everyone, welcome to Pepper TV. I'm Kelly Pepper.
And I'm Gracious Kate, and right now you're back for another instalment of Pepper TV.
We've got two amazing acts for you this week, and you're going to see a few live performances as well.
Cool. Before we get into that, there's this new thing we've installed.
For 2014.
Called the Marshmallow Challenge. Basically, the Marshmallow Challenge simply is stuff as many marshmallows in your mouth under the time limit of 30 seconds. And because everyone keeps complaining that they don't know what it means and they don't know how to do it, even though that was straightforward, I'm the mug that's volunteered to be the first one to take out the challenge.
Are you up for it?
No, but apparently.
Right, okay, we've come prepared. I've got all the marshmallows ready.
So.
Are you ready to go? Have we got 30 seconds ready to go?
Not really, so. Let me just size this up because, you know, you can't just be putting loads of marshmallows in your mouth. You need to get your mind right. You know what I'm saying? So I'm ready. And okay. Obviously everyone else home is ready to watch me mug myself. So let's go.
On your marks, get set, go! All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, it's so good. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Are you done? Is this nearly done? Can you feel any more? 16.
30 seconds.
Right, 30 seconds. That's it. Okay, whilst Gracious sorts himself out, I'm going to introduce the first act. Our first act today is a 16-year-old afrobeat star making massive waves in the music industry. Her name is Zafi B. Hey everyone, Pepper TV here, and I'm on the sofa with Zafi B. How are you today?
I'm good, thanks, you?
Yeah, I'm very good, thank you. Right, so you're only 16 and you're making big waves already on the afrobeat music scene.
Yeah.
Tell me about what you've been up to.
Basically, a couple months ago, I decided to go into the music industry and I made my new single number one, which I'm very proud of, in the afrobeat genre. So yeah, I've been working on new songs since then, so yeah.
So literally just 2 months ago you decided to go for it and you've made all this big impact
right.
So far.
Right.
What influenced you to go for it then?
Basically, I go to Sylvia Young Theatre School every Saturday. I've been in Holby City, Doctor Who, Oliver Twist the Musical in the West End. So ever since a young age, I've had the help of music and drama in my life, from my parents, from Sylvia. So I just thought music has always been a part of me, so I might as well just go into it and not waste a technique that I have and I can pursue a dream in. So.
Yeah, definitely. It's a waste of talent.
Exactly.
Isn't it? Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay, so why did you choose to go for the Afrobeat style?
Well, obviously I'm from Ghana, so Afrobeat has always been inside of me. I love the beats it has, and I just thought it's not really my kind of thing to do pop music. I feel more better with me doing Afrobeats, more of an African genre. So me going to Afrobeats is more what I feel comfortable and what I like to do. So.
Yeah, well, you've got to be true to yourself.
Exactly.
Okay, and your single number one was released last month.
Right.
There's a video for it. Right. Talk us through the video.
My video is now been on YouTube. I filmed at Sylvia Young Theatre School, obviously where I go. It was a very, very big like thing for me because I finally done a video shoot. Like, been my dream to do a video. Finally done it. So being 16 as well, it's a big thing as well. So I shoot it in Sylvia Young with like my friends and everything. So. Yeah, I
did. Okay. So what's the theme of the song and the video, and what's the message?
Well, basically, it's the theme of me looking at a boy and like deciding that he's my number one, that he's my everything. He's like basically my number one, like a fairy tale.
So not based on a true story then, if you said fairy tale.
No, it's not a true story, just a little theme going through, a little fairy tale imagination kind of thing.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah. Nice to dream. Okay. So what have you got coming up over the next few months and the next year then for 2014?
Well, obviously I'm going to be in the studio more, doing more songs with different producers, going to get like a different kind of hearing of the same kind of music.
Okay.
And hopefully I'll create my new album, which I'm very looking forward to. And I just want to get my album out, which I'm so thrilled for. So
Okay, brilliant. Well, we're going to take a quick look at the video now. Here we go.
I don't care about the same. We are the number one. If I was to walk away, we are sure 7 for them. We're the baby era.
can our viewers go and buy it?
You can find it on iTunes and also YouTube. Feel free to check it out.
Okay, lovely. And for anyone looking for you online, where can they find you online?
You can find me mainly on Twitter at ZafiBXX and all the other social networking sites.
Okay, brilliant. Mm-hmm. So you're going to perform for us just before you go. So what are you going to perform for us?
I'm going to perform my new single, Number One, by me, Zafi B.
Okay, lovely. Right, here we go, guys. Check her out online, and this is Zafi B, Number One.
I'm interviewing the singer-songwriter, Tom Cox. What's going on, people? Right now, I'm sitting down with the ever so talented Mr. Tom Cox, and welcome to Pepper TV.
Thank you very much, man.
So, tell us a bit about yourself for the people who don't know.
So, I'm a singer-songwriter. Mm-hmm. I've been living in Norwich most of my life. I've been in London for 3 years now. I went to drama school, and I've been writing music since I was about 10 years old. So 12 years now. And I'm doing an EP next year, my debut EP, which should come out like just before March, we're hoping.
Wow, it's kind of like an influx of information in like a couple seconds. So then, how old are you, would you say?
22.
Obviously, would you say 22 now? So you've been doing music for 12 years?
Yeah.
It's a long time to kind of, have you ever taken a break, or has it constantly been on the go?
Like, especially since I moved to London, it's been like more intense than it ever has been, because like obviously, the gigs are kind of more open and like more appealing to a lot of people. Yeah. But back in Norwich, like the music scene's brilliant. Like it's quite small, so you kind of, when a new person pops up, you go and see them perform. it's quite exciting to go and see that. But yeah, I mean, I wasn't really taking it that seriously when I was like 10 years old, obviously, but like I'd be writing lyrics and everything, and you look back on them now, they're quite funny, but you know, that's how you grow as an artist, I guess. You just get better and like craft.
So then, would you say you have a particular sound?
Yeah, it's kind of been growing quite recently, since I finished drama school. I'm kind of honing in on, like, I do a lot of spoken word. A lot of people might mistake it for rap. I guess it is rap. Rap's just a form of poetry.
Yeah, it's like a, you know what I mean? It's like a specialised form.
Exactly, yeah. I don't mean just a form of poetry. It's much more than that. But it's a really good way for me to vent and get my ideas down on paper. When I sing, it's more, you know, it's very melodic, obviously, but I kind of, I get my ideas across a lot better when I rap, I guess.
So then with the spoken word, does it have a particular rhyme scheme, or is it just random, whatever kind of comes out?
Well, this song that I'm going to play, The Collection, that took me like 4 years to write, and then it took like 2 days to actually write it. So it took 4 years to kind of pluck the courage to put all the thoughts together, and then 2 days to kind of formulate it into a song, I guess. And then the other ones, I've got a song called Lately, and that's kind of about, you know, past relationships and everything. And on the EP, we're releasing a free track at the end. It's going to be about 9-10 minutes long. It's called 6 Months. And each verse, it's about when my my ex-girlfriend moved away to Australia. And, you know, it didn't quite work out. So I'm writing each verse where I was at 6 months, at 5 months, and then the last verse will be where I am at the time of writing it. So it'll be 7 months, and then it'll end.
It's quite deep.
Yeah.
It's quite interesting. You know, it's good to kind of get into the artist's mind, because when people write songs, a lot of people these days, they just write a song for the sake of it.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of thought or a story behind it, and I think that's kind of where the best comes out.
Yeah, definitely, I agree. I can't really just sit down and write a song for the sake of writing a song. I have to, like, I don't know, anything might have happened that day. Anything, you know, I got a phone call, something bad's happened at home, or something good happened, or, you know,
you do draw out from the kind of things that happen.
I can't, like, to be fair, I'm getting better at it. We're trying to kind of put together a kind of radio-friendly kind of song, so it kind of gets people a bit interested, but then they can kind of see, like, the darker, more intense side that I do. But I can sit down and write, like, a pop song. I just don't find it as exciting or interesting for me as an artist.
So then your main kind of thing you stay away from, if you could, you stay away from that and kind of delve into it?
I'd like to anyway, but, you know, sometimes it is fun to write. Sometimes it's fun to write like a nice, like, anthemic song, do you know what I mean? And like hear people singing along to it.
People who don't know where to find you, is there anything on YouTube or Twitter? Instagram, anything like that?
I'm on Twitter at CoxySound, and then facebook.com/TomCoxMusic. I kind of find the social media stuff quite tricky, because, you know, since, like, I remember since the days of, like, Lily Allen, where it kind of all stemmed there for her. And so since then, and since, like, the invention of Facebook and, like, how YouTube's blown up and everything, I find it quite hard to, like, break away from the mold and, like, make myself a bit different, you know, and I could just do cover after cover after cover and stick it all on YouTube. And I probably should, to be perfectly honest.
You can do a few, but at the same time, you got to stick with what makes you you, you know?
Yeah, definitely. So, I mean, I'm always on there, like, always promoting and everything. But you have to get out there, and you have to play, and you have to release stuff for people to actually get really engaged.
Most definitely. You heard it there, people, where you can find him, what he's been doing. Do you have a set release date for the EP?
We're looking to do it before March the 5th, before my birthday, because I'm looking to kind of, you know, do show BBC Introducing, all those kind of people stuff, and, you know, before the summer season, so I can maybe get some festivals and things.
Okay, well, this has been very interesting, and you know, thank you for enlightening me.
Thanks very much, man. Thank you.
It's been good. Before we sign in and sign up, there's something I need to ask if you'd be up for doing.
Yeah.
We have this thing called the Marshmallow Challenge.
Okay.
Don't worry about the name, but basically, it's a game where you try and stuff as many marshmallows in your mouth, and then we keep a score.
Nice.
I've done it. I can't tell you how many I got, because then obviously, you know, it's going to be problems. But are you up for trying?
Yeah, definitely.
Can we have the marshmallows, please?
Alright, are you ready for this?
For everyone, this is, you know,
I'll pop them down next then.
This is Kelly Pepper, obviously, as it says up there. So, we have roughly quite a few marshmallows left.
Yep.
And then, we need theme music, you know? I'm gonna do some theme music. Alright, you ready? Let me go.
Me first or you first?
I've done mine.
Oh, is it just me?
I've been sick already. It's up to you.
Right.
One, two, that wasn't three, but he's cheating. Right, he's got four. He's got five.
Mm-hmm.
He's got six. He hasn't thrown up yet. Keep going. No, we gotta keep going. There's no, can we chew and swallow?
Mm-mm.
You have 30 seconds. You have 30 seconds, by the way. This is just stuff I'm improvising on the way. Rob, how many is that? Eight. That's seven. Keep going. That's eight. He's turning red. Keep
Stop.
Going. So you was able to do, how many? How many was that? Eight. Cool. You haven't beaten me, but basically, right now, you look really stupid, but it's been good. But it's been good. Everyone.
Right, okay, that's it for another episode of Pepper TV. Big thank you to Zafi B and to Tom Cox for stopping down today.
And don't forget, you can catch Pepper TV on the first Wednesday of every month with more of that good stuff, open mics, performances, and marshmallow challenges.
I can't wait for the marshmallow challenges. Okay, but before we go today, here's an explosive performance for us. It's Tom Cox.
See, I made a pledge that if I was ever to make it, I would put aside the money I needed for my braces. For my self-consciousness is a form of hatred when you're a 22-year-old with teeth that are covered in the matrix. But the fact really remains that, could I be accepted as an actor with train tracks, surrounding my teeth like money to a made man? It's awful to believe I think this will make me a great man. Because I'm scared to smile from some words that I heard. Someone should have sorted this out a long time ago. But I'm a grown man now, I better listen and learn that these things take patience and it's gonna take a little while, you know? I believe that a beautiful body is wasted supporting a face with no personality. And imagine if these were the words they made the Bible from. Imagine the feeling of being in love with someone that you're frightened of. It's been so long, and if it wasn't for Facebook, there's a worry in my head I might forget how your face looks. You see, when you're on one side of the world and the one that you need is on the other one, mathematically speaking, half and half together should have the same one. But the truth is, said person's living a dream that rests on my pillow every night. I had every opportunity, I even took a gap year to make my dream come to life. When you want something so, so badly and it's right there for the taking, you think it'll be there in years to come for you sitting patiently waiting. This isn't the case, it'll get further away, you can no longer run fast enough to chase it. And now I find myself in a relationship with a girl called Skype. Do you know how lonely that makes me? And if this is hard for you to relate to, I try and find common ground for us to level. You're late for work, you stare into the eyes of your boss, who has the eyes of the devil. Saying this is the fifth time this month, what makes you think you're so special? You know what, you're fired, kid, I can find someone within an hour who can stick to a schedule. But sir, you don't understand, I promise I'm not making excuses. I tried to call Kathy on reception, she didn't pick up and I can prove it. I know I'm an hour late and my explanation may seem useless, but I was up all night with my newborn and I know you know how hard raising a youth is. Boss says I'm sorry. It's company procedure, I want you gone in five. Who the hell do you think you are? I'm waiting to reply. But the bigger man is there inside of me, sir. Thank you so much for the ride. I understand I've let me down, but you show me everything I need to make something of my life. Let me speak ironically. If a man on the streets has been homeless his whole entire life, he's never been homeless because there was never one to lose in the first place. If you get mugged on the way to the jewelry store to buy your girlfriend a ring, would you chase him, tell the police, or do the exact same damn thing? Because through times of desperation, man has been known to be a violent thing. And I've had my fair share of problems through anger, alcohol, and depression, and that's why I choose to sing. It's called venting. You should all try it. The world, it might rotate better. We can unravel problems to see just how big yours really are with the tape measure. And now it feels like my favorite habit is becoming a hindrance. My liver and my money organ are being damaged by binging. And surely it's not a good sign if I sometimes fall asleep clenching my liver to keep on living. But it's clear to me that abuse is a sore sight. I'll get more drunk than all you do in a fortnight. And that's not me bragging, that's just how it is. A man who can no longer defend himself with the willpower that is powerless. And I'm sorry if your shadows have offended. I've got a problem with booze, but I'm not dependent. and I really, from the bottom of my heart, hope that sinks in. I'm 22 years old, but I feel 40 because of drinking. And I'm guilty of not visiting my grandparents based on how far away they are. I'm desperate to say thank you. Happy birthday, I love you to their face and not in the form of a Hallmark card. Tell me who's wrong, dear Tom, back to the paper with a new song, yeah. But I'm still unsure, and I say, yeah. I'm still unsure, and I say, tell me who's wrong. Gonna do Tom, back to the paper, writing a new song, yeah. But I'm still unsure, and I say, yeah. I'm still unsure.